Next topic is to solve a linear differential equation of second order by removing the first derivative and changing the dependent variable. In this exercise, we will solve the linear differential equation of second order. We will remove the first derivative term and change the dependent variable. There are steps to solve the equation by this method, total 5 steps. We will learn these steps with the example. Let's start the exercise. 6.2, first question. Solve the differential equation by removing the first derivative. The equation is d square y by dx square minus 2 by x dy by dx plus a square plus 2 by x square into y equal to 0. First step is to check whether we can solve this equation by this method or not. For that, we need to find p dash. Learn this formula. P dash is equal to q minus 1 by 4 p square minus 1 by 2 derivative of p with respect to x. Now in this differential equation, p is this and q is this. So we find p dash. This is our step 1 to find p dash. And check whether the equation, if p dash comes out to be constant or of the form constant by x square, then only the equation will be solved by this method, otherwise not. So first we find p dash. P dash is equal to q. Q is a square 2 by x square minus 1 by 4. P square is minus 2 by x. Minus 2 by x square, that is 4x square. Minus 1 by 2 derivative of p with respect to x. Minus 2 by x derivative will be minus minus plus 2 by x square. So this comes out to be a square plus 2 by x square minus 1 by x square minus 1 by x square. Cancel out. This is a square. Now this is the main part. If p dash comes out to be constant or of the form constant by x square, then only this method is applied. Now in this question it is constant, that is a square, so we can apply this method. Now we find the value of v. In step 2 we find the value of u is equal to e raised to power minus 1 by 2 integration p dx. So for this question, u is e raised to power minus 1 by 2, p is integration minus 2 by x dx. It comes out to be e raised to power integration 1 by x dx. So that is e raised to power log x, which is equal to x. So for this question, u comes out to be x. Otherwise, we have to learn this formula for finding u is equal to e raised to power minus 1 by 2 integration p dx. Now we know the value of u. So in step 3 says that put y is equal to u into v. And the given equation will be transformed in the form of double derivative of v with respect to x square plus p dash v equal to q dash, where value of q dash is equal to r by u. This is p, this is q, and the term on the right hand side will be r. So now the transformed equation will be double derivative of v with respect to x plus p dash v. P dash we have already found in this question, it is a square, equal to q dash. Q dash is equal to r by u, and here in this question r is 0. So this is 0. We get d square u by d x square plus p dash value is a square v equal to q dash, here is 0. We have let this y is equal to u into v. From here we find the value of v. Now this is direct linear differential equation with constant coefficient, because coefficient here are constant, so it is a linear differential equation with constant coefficient. So we will write d square minus plus a square v equal to 0. Now we write auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is d square plus a square equal to 0. From here d square is equal to minus a square, that is value of d is plus minus a iota. Now d is plus minus a iota, so v is equal to, it is complex conjugate roots are there, so v is equal to c1 cos ax plus c2 sin ax. So the solution of the given equation is y was equal to u into v. In this question u was equal to x and v here is c1 cos ax plus c2 sin ax, hence the solution. Next we do question number 11. 11th question is double derivative minus 2 tangent x dy by dx plus 5y is equal to secant x into e raised to power x. Now with first step was to check whether this is solvable in this type of form or not. For that we have to find the value of p dash. P dash is equal to q minus 1 by 4 p square minus 1 by 2 derivative of p with respect to x. Q is 5 minus 1 by 4 p square is minus 2, that is 4 tangent square 1 by 2 derivative of p with respect to x. Tangent derivative of tangent x is secant square x. So this comes out to be 5 secant square x minus tangent square x, that is equal to 1, 5 plus 1, 6. As p dash is constant, so we can solve this by this, solve this question by this method. Now we find the value of u. U is equal to e raised to power minus 1 by 2 integration p dx. E raised to power minus 1 by 2 integration p over here is minus 2 tangent x dx. E raised to power integration tangent x dx. Integration of tangent x is minus log secant x. Sorry, integration of tangent x is log secant x. So it comes out to be secant x. We found the value of u. Now we put y is equal to u into v and we will get the transformed equation as double derivative of v with respect to x plus p dash. P dash is 6 v equal to q dash. Q dash is our r by u. R here is secant x into e raised to power x divided by secant x, so it comes out to be e raised. So our differential equation will be square v by d square plus 6 v is equal to e raised to power x. Now in symbolic form we can write it as b square plus 6 into v is equal to e raised to power x. Now auxiliary equation d square plus 6 equal to 0. From here we get the value of d as plus minus iota root 6. So v from here is we have to find pi. From here we can only write complementary function comes out to be c1 cos root 6 x plus c2 sin root 6 x. Now we find pi is equal to 1 by d square plus 6 operating on e raised to power x. Directly we will put d as equal to 1, so 1 plus 6 is 7, so it comes out to be e raised to power x by 7. So we write complete solution, that is value of v will be equal to complementary function plus pi. Complementary function is c1 cos root 6 x plus c2 sin root 6 x plus pi, that is e raised to power x by 7. Now we know the value of v and we know the value of u, so y will be equal to u into v, that is u was secant x into c1 cos root 6 x plus c2 sin root 6 x plus e raised to power x by 7. Hence this is the solution for the next. We try 21st question. 21st question is double derivative of y with respect to x plus 2x dy by dx plus x square plus 1 into y is equal to x cube plus 3x. Firstly we find p dash is equal to q minus 1 by 4 p square minus 1 by 2 derivative of p with respect to x. It's x cube plus 3x square. This is our p, this is our q, and this is our r. X square plus 1. Q is x square plus 1. Minus 1 by 4 p square is 4x square. Minus 1 by 2 derivative of that is 2. So it comes out to be x square plus 1 minus x square minus 1, that is 0. Since the value of p dash is constant, so we can apply this method. Now we find the value of u, which u is equal to e raised to power minus 1 by 2 integration p dx. This comes out e raised to power minus 1 by 2 integration of 2x dx. Integration of 2x will be x square, so it is e raised to power minus x square by 2. Now u is this. Let y is equal to u into v, and our transformed equation will be double derivative of v with respect to x plus p dash v. P dash is 0 into v is equal to q dash, and q dash is equal to r by u. Here r is x cube plus 3x and u is e raised to power minus x square by 2. So this equation is double derivative of v with respect to x square is with respect to x is equal to x cube plus 3x into e raised to power x square by 2. Now from here let's do the integration on both the sides. We get dv by dx is equal to integration x cube plus 3x e raised to power x square by 2 with respect to x plus C1, let us put x square by 2 equal to t. From here, 2x by 2 dx is equal to dt. Let's take L, so this integration will become dv by dx is equal to integration, taking x common, x square plus 3. X square is equal to, it will be x square plus 3 na, x square is 2t plus 3 e raised to power t, and x was common, x into dx will be replaced by dt plus c1. Taking this as doing the integration by part, taking this as first and this as second, we get integration 2t plus 3 as it is, integration of e raised to power t is e raised to power t, minus derivative of this will be 2, integration of e raised to power t is power 3, doing it in single step, plus its derivative will be 0, so it's vanish c1, and now we replace t by x square, replacing it we get 2t is equal to x square plus 3 e raised to power x square by 2 minus 2 e raised to power x square by 2 plus c1, taking e raised to power x square common, e raised to power x square by 2 common, it is x square plus 3 minus 2, that is x square plus 1 and plus c1. Now value of dv by dx is this. Now integration of this with respect to x, we get v is equal to integration x square plus 1 into e raised to power x square by 2 plus integration of c1 x plus c2. We find the differentiation of e raised to power x square by 2, x into e raised to power x square by 2. Differentiation of this will be equal to x as it is, differentiation of this is e raised to power x square by 2 into 2x by 2, that is x square plus, now here e raised to power x square by 2 as it is, differentiation of x is 1. From here we get x square plus 1 e raised to power x square by 2, that is differentiation of this function is x into e raised to power x square by, differentiation of x e raised to power x square by 2 is x square plus 1 into e raised to power x square by 2. So integration of this function will be x e raised to power x square by 2. Writing it over here, integration of this will be x e raised to power x square by 2 plus c1x plus c2. Now v is this, we have already find out. We get the value of y. Y is equal to u into v. U was e raised to power minus x square by 2 into v is x e raised to power x square by 2 plus c1x plus c2. This comes out to be x plus c1x plus c2 into e raised to power minus x square by